Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Bogey McSandtrap Career Mode series here in Rory McIlroy PGA Tour Golf on the Xbox One. Now, Bogey McSandtrap has just come off a victory on the International Classic. He's moving on to the EA Sports Spring Invitational next, and this will be four rounds of golf at Wolf Creek Golf Club in Mesquite, Nevada. All right, looks like a very interesting course to try to tackle, and we're going to do just that in a second here. Getting Bogey McSandtrap right back into the mix. Now, he's the leaderboard on this year's FedEx Cup standings. I don't have those right in front of me here, but I believe he's got a healthy lead after that last victory in the International Classic. He's hoping maybe some competition steps up here. Maybe Rory McIlroy or maybe somebody else there can give him a run for his money in this, the EA Sports Spring Invitational. So there you see the board starting out. Bogey obviously hasn't teed off his day yet. And oh my goodness, cover your eyes. What is he wearing today? First of all, that clashes. And yeah, I think he's just going for some kind of shock value. You know, he's always a colorful kind of guy. And I guess he's just expressing that today and maybe even trying to throw his fellow competitors off a little bit, having to look at that. But my goodness, who dressed you? He obviously dressed in the dark this morning. His approach shot on this par five, he gets past the flag. Okay, how about that? He's on the green and he's got an eagle putt, 21 feet. Can he sink it? Oh, he gave it too much. Frank, it was right on line, but too much. Yeah, and he's not going to get that eagle putt. All right, so let's putt for birdie and get that, right? There you go. He sinks the birdie putt. So he starts his day off one under on the first hole. Good job here. Okay, this is quite an interesting course. This is quite a difference from coming from the International Classic at Royal Troon, where it was pretty much flat. And now you've got a lot of altitude here, a lot of up and down on this course to deal with. So it's a very different challenge. He's got a birdie putt right here on two. You know me and my putting. For those of you who say aim the putts, I aim the putts. Sometimes I edit it where you don't see the aim, but there you go. I aimed that one right in. I'm not saying my aim is always right, but I do aim the putts. Okay, so par three. Can't even see the hole from where we're teeing off, and he leaves that short and in the rough. Okay, this is a hole that I think is going to be trouble all week, as it's kind of hard to figure this one out distance-wise. Okay, nice recovery right there. A little farther from the flag than we would have wanted, but we'll deal with it because we're on the green in two and we're putting for par. Once again, lining this up. Let's see how close we are. Right on, but again, a little too hard. We're going to have to take a bogey on this one as it will not go down. So he gets the tap in, but yeah, bogey right there. And he's back to negative one after three holes. Fourth place right now, currently. A lot of golf left, even just in this first round. You see the blimp is hovering around there, and the blimp has a nice look at him hitting the bunker. So, yeah, well, there's the other part of his namesake. He'll be hitting from the sand trap right now. Oh, look at that, though. Wow, he gets out of there quite nicely and leaves himself pretty good putt there to get himself a birdie. So he goes from the sand trap to... Oh, no! How does he miss that putt? That putt was a gimme. He missed it. Okay, I have to address one thing now. I thought it was quite hilarious in the comments in two videos ago, I guess it was. People were like, yeah, I think you're playing bad on purpose. No, you guys are giving me too much credit. I don't play bad on purpose. I make bad putts. I make bad decisions on lining up putts. I make some interesting tee shots into the rough and sometimes. No, I'm not doing it on purpose. I'm trying to play well on every hole I play. You're giving me too much credit. So there is a birdie putt. He'll take that and move back to two under and get a piece of the lead. But yeah, no, it's pretty preposterous for you guys to say that I'm actually like throwing holes out there or something like that. I'm nowhere on that level to have the luxury to be able to do that. Here is a second shot on a par four that's going to set us up on the green. Yeah, when you see me messing up, yeah, that's not intentional. It's just I'm not very good. And you know what? there was some other comments saying, you know, you really suck at this. Well, you know, I just have to chuckle right because, I mean, people say that about it just about every game I play on YouTube. But you know what? It's not about my skill level. It's about me having fun, about me sharing the story of a career mode or a franchise or, you know, whatever it might be with my subscribers, with my viewers. We all kind of just get to have a fun time with it. The main bottom line is that I have fun playing this. Obviously, I'm having fun playing this game a lot because it's kind of addicting. Just ask Tubby Emu. He got the game too, and he's like sending me messages on Haytel left and right. Oh, I just missed this shot and this, that. I'm like, I can't put this down. I'm like, you going to ever edit any of this and show some people some videos? Oh, I just can't stop playing. Well, you know, I'm kind of got the same thing. It's kind of like an escape game for me. Yes, it's in the sports realm. It's not my typical games that I'm playing, my baseball, basketball, hockey, football, but it's like a really cool diversion for me. I'm really enjoying it. So bottom line is, yeah, I know I suck at the game, but that's not the point. I'm having fun, and that's a birdie putt. Okay, some of my putts are going today. All right, starting to maybe make a run, 5 under now, and we've got a lead opening up. We're on the 12th now for birdie. Can he make this one? Yep, he's got that one too. Should be 6 under now and 3 ahead of the pace. So I guess bottom line, what I'm getting at is as far as the comments and stuff, don't get me wrong. I love the comments. I love reading the comments. I love them good, bad, constructive criticism, crazy off the wall. The comments are all fun to read. But I guess my bottom line is, you know, you got to take it with a grain of salt. There is no real difficulty setting on this game. You can change some of the things that you use as far as, like, you know, mapping out your shot and having some aids and things like that, but there are no real attribute sliders on here. There's no difficulty setting. We're playing this to have fun, and if it's not ultra realistic, then oh well, we're having fun. I mean, the guy's name is Bogey McSantrap. Did you really think this was going to be an ultra realistic situation we had going? No, we're playing for fun. So, you know, if you can enjoy that, cool. If it's a problem for you, I don't know. Maybe there's another more realistic Rory McIlroy golf series out there. I don't know a whole lot of people that are doing it. I haven't really searched either. This shot on the par 3. Nice one on the green. It's rolling. It's rolling. It's rolling. Oh, he didn't just do that. He's already having a great round, but he just got his very first hole in one. Very first ace. Puts him 9 under. All of a sudden, he's dominating this first round. Whoa. Hole-in-one, was not expecting that whatsoever. He got a second shot right here that's going to get close to the flag and roll away a little bit. Man, I think he's still basking in the glow of that ace, though. Man, oh, man, here's a birdie putt. Going to make it? Yes. Okay. And look at it. He's going to break out the sprinkler dance. Yes. Love it. I love that they don't take themselves too seriously in this game. You can get some Happy Gilmore moments. I mean, it doesn't need to be total arcadey. I mean, I know the nightclub challenges, they're very much arcade feel to them. And, of course, you've got a battlefield golf course in this game, which is very arcade-like as well. But, I don't know. Bottom line is I'm having a lot of fun. And so is Bogey McSantrap in this round, apparently. He's really excited that he's left himself a 10-foot eagle putt. Yeah, we had an ace. Why not an eagle, too? Flex! Flex! He's kind of looking like the Hulk with those green pants. So why not go out there and flex? He's 12 under now. My goodness. Somebody else has got to have a run. Someone else has got to be enjoying this course today like Bogey is as well. Because he is just tearing it up, especially on the back nine. The back nine's really where he caught fire. Got that hole in one, and now he's charging here. A birdie attempt on 18 to end off a very special day, and he gets it. He gets it. Take that swing for the fences, Bogey. It is gone. You had a great first round, and I would not expect a round like that again in this tournament. Just saying, that's going to be hard to top. So there you go, 69 overall with the attributes. And we look at the leaderboard, and, well, David Hearn had a nice day at 7 under. Probably expected to be leading with that kind of score, but no, because Bogey is just killing it right now. Come on back for the second round here at Wolf Creek Golf Club. I wouldn't expect that kind of score again, but maybe he can keep it consistent and stay on the leaderboard. We'll see you next time for more Bogey McSantrap. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU. as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!